How do you determine what your house is worth? If you're considering on selling and you're just not sure how to price your home, or you're considering on buying a house and you want to make sure you consider all the factors when you're placing an offer, I hope this video will help you in answering some of your questions. I'm Stephanie Souza Bro, and I'm here to help you determine how you will price your home when you go to market. There's a few things to consider. You need to consider size, condition, location, marketing, and negotiating. They all have a huge effect on the price. And think about it, you can't necessarily compare a 2,000 square foot house to a 4,000 square foot house. That would be like comparing a Maserati to a Hyundai. They just don't match. They're not comparable. You need to make sure you're comparing the size just like an appraiser would. So in most cases, if there is enough inventory, an appraiser likes to go anywhere from 200 to 400 square feet difference, both higher and lower, to use as comparables to determine the pricing. If there's not enough inventory, they'll make adjustments in their evaluation of what the home is worth based upon difference in sizes. Now let's talk about condition. Again, think about this in relation to a car. You can't compare a beat up old hoopty to a brand new shiny car, right? Well, a home is the same thing. When you're pricing, you have to look at things like how upgraded is your house? How modern is it? What's the landscaping like? Are you in a great location? Are you close to freeways and shopping? How does your area compare to other houses in the areas? Are there any nuisances like power poles, heavy traffic, or anything else that could be considered undesirable? To learn more about marketing, watch the video on marketing your home. But remember, when pricing, it's natural to feel like your home is worth more than everybody else's because we have an emotional attachment to it. But you've got to look at all the variables, because underpricing your home will cause you to lose money, but so will overpricing your home.